So in this video, I'll be bringing you a quick tutorial on how you can use the debug or console mode in EU5. Now, to get the game to load up in debug mode, you want to go to your games library in Steam and right click on the game's title. You then want to left click on properties. And then when you get this screen up on the left hand side, you want to be in general. And then where it says launch options, you want to type -debug_mode like I've done here. Now, once you are in game, you will be able to tell if you are in debug mode by pressing the tilde key on your keyboard. And then you should get this menu come up on the left. I'm just going to run through a few of the main commands that you can use. But if you do want a full list of what commands you can use, then in the console, you can type in help log. And then what that will do is it will print you a text command that will be in your EU5 folder, which will be in your documents. So the first one we're going to cover is pretty basic. It's your gold. So if you want more cash, then you can simply type cash and then whatever number you want. And then as you see, I type cash 1000 and it adds 1000 gold. And the next one we're going to quickly run through is stability. Now, stability in EU5 is basically your country's like sanity meter. So the higher it is, the smoother everything runs. You get less revolt risk, better income and faster reforms and stuff like that. Now, one thing to note is this is capped at 100. So if you see, our stability at the moment is 29. So if we just type 80, it caps out at 100. Now, obviously, if you want minus, you just put, say, minus 50, and then it will take away. Same with your money and many other stats in here as well. Now, if you want to play as another country like mid-game, you can do that. All you have to do is use your cursor to highlight the country, and you will see in the debug text, it will say tag equals and the country code. So for France, it is FRA. And then what you will type is you will type in tag and then FRA, and we are now playing as France. Now, another command you can use is observe. So if you don't want to play as any country and you just want to observe the world and just watch what everybody does, you can just type in observe. Another stat we can edit is war exhaustion. Now, obviously, at the moment we have zero. So if you want to change that amount, you simply type war exhaustion and then whatever number you want to in here. And then as you can see, typing 100, it now gives us 19.1. And then same again, if you want to lower it, you just do minus instead. Now, some handy commands are stuff like instant construction, which obviously means that your buildings and stuff will instantly build. You have instant siege if you don't want to wait for your castle sieges, you know, they just happen instantly. And then you have instant move, you know, for your troops if you want them to move instantly. Now, remove fog of war will enable you to see every army and every fleet and stuff like that. If you do have a siege going on, you can then type win siege and then the location code. And you find that by zooming in, picking a province, and then you will see it's got location tag or location ID. I haven't actually got a siege going on right now, but you will simply type win siege and then it'll either be this number here or it'll be the actual tag. You can use yes man if you want other countries to basically say yes to any of your demands or requests, or you can use no man if you want them to decline every request that you have. You can use fast diplo, and that means things like alliances, marriages, peace offers, guarantees, etc. They will all happen instantly. And you can use instant war, which basically takes away the prepare for war time, so it happens immediately. You can use clear AI objectives and then the country code. We spoke about how to get that earlier. So if you put France, and then what that will do is it will clear all the AI objectives for France. The AI will essentially forget, you know, its current plans and reevaluate from scratch. Now, if you want to change your government type, then if you click on your flag here and then go to this crown and then go up to government type, you will see here are the different government types. So in the console, you will then type in change government and then whatever type of government you want to change to. So we could just go for republic and then your government has changed. Now, changing your religion will work slightly different. You will put in religion and then just say you wanted to change to Buddhism. You could put Buddhist, but it won't work. And that's basically because you have to put the specific religion. And the best way to do that is to right click on the game in your Steam library and then manage and then browse local files. And then you want to go to game and then in game, then go to the common folder. And then if you scroll down, you will see a folder called religions. And in here will be every single religion in the game. So if we click on the Buddhist file, and as you see, there's one here called Bon. So now if we go back to game and we go to religion and then type Bon, and then it will actually change to that religion. Now you can add favor, and then the code of the country that you want to owe favor to you. So let's do France again. Then you can just type in an amount. And then that means that France now owes us a score of 50 favors. And basically, favors are diplomatic points you earn over time, like with your allies. So you can use them to like call another country to help you in a war, or you can demand land, or it can influence the diplomacy. Now, if you want to form a union with another country, you can type form underscore union, and then once again, the country code. And now we have a union with France, where we are the senior partner and they are the junior. So basically, we are the head of that union. Now you can add institution progress simply by typing add underscore institution underscore progress. And then once again, in the game's files in your common folder, you will find a folder called institution, and that will have all the institutions in there. So basically, you open one of those files, find the name of one of them, and then that's what you will type in here. So for this example, we can put the Renaissance. And then what you need to do then is you need to find a location tag of where it will start. So for our country, let's say we want it to start in Grimsby. You will see it says Grimsby there for the location tag. So we will type that. And then you will type a percentage of how complete that institution progress is. So we'll just go for 100%. And there you go. You can see the Renaissance has started in Grimsby. Now, if you want to be really mean and start a famine in another country, you can use the tag command, then choose the country that you want to change to. So let's go to France, and then we can type in famine. And then all their food is gone, so unlucky France. Now, some other commands you can use if you want to be mean is you can type damage all units and then the country code. And now that means all units in France have been damaged. If you want to be even meaner than that, then you can go to kill all units. And now all units are killed. And finally, if you want to change the weather in a certain location, then you will put weather and then you look for the location tag again. So we just use Grimsby again. And then you type the type of weather that you want, so we just put tornado, and now new weather has spawned in Grimsby. But like I said at the start, plenty more commands, so print out that help log. And if you want more help with EU5, then make sure you hit that subscribe button and leave me a comment below. But thanks for watching, and until next time.